Siamo a Barcellona per la seconda edizione dell'ISIAT, l'International Symposium of Intra-Articular Treatment. Tanti temi trattati, anche di estrema avanguardia, come per esempio la terapia genica. Di questo ha parlato il professor Evans della Harvard Medical School e abbiamo appunto il piacere e l'onore di parlare con lui per farci raccontare un pochettino di cosa si tratta. Allora, professor Evans, why you decided to study the possibilities, the therapeutic possibilities of gene therapy?
Yeah, that's a very good question because osteoarthritis is not a traditional genetic disease in the sense we're usually used to thinking about them. And we're in this case, we're using gene therapy as a way to treat the patient in a lasting fashion. So the idea is if we transfer a gene into an osteoarthritic joint, that gene will be expressed and will persist for the duration of the disease to have a lasting treatment. Whereas any other way to try to do it will not work because when you normally inject something into a joint, it comes out very quickly. A gene will stay there and deliver its therapeutic effect for a long time.
Which type of gene are you thinking about, and how you will convey the gene into the interarticular space?
So we've been very interested in the effects of a substance called interleukin-1 as a mediator of the osteoarthritic process in joints. And nature provides us with an occurring, naturally occurring inhibitor known as the interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, which is a small protein that's made naturally by the body. And what we do is we take the gene that makes that protein, put it in a virus that we engineer so that it's not harmful, but is able to infect cells in the joint, transfer the gene, and we then inject that virus into the joint. When it's in the joint, it infects joint cells. The joints make the gene product, the interleukin-1 receptor antagonist, for a long period of time, and it addresses the various pathologies within the joint.
There are already on the market drugs whose mechanism whose target is the interleukin-1. For example, there are anakinra and canakinumab.
Yes.
Which are the difference between these drugs and the gene therapy you are studying?
Ah, well, the gene product that's made by our gene therapy is actually the same as anakinra kineret. The difference is that if you put anakinra in a joint, it comes out in 4 hours, and any therapeutic effect is very short. If we put the virus in that makes the anakinra now within the joint all the time, there's a stronger effect and it lasts for the duration of the disease.
Let's go to the results, to the data. Which data are available so far?
So far, this has been shown to work in various different animals with experimental osteoarthritis, and we're encouraged because of that to try to do it in humans. And we're now in the process of going through the regulatory process with the Food and Drug Administration in the United States.
When are you planning to start the first dose in human?
Well, we're in the middle of a large safety study in rats. This is something that the Food and Drug Administration required us to do. And that should be finished at the end of this year. And if there are no problems, we would hope to start the first patient next year.
So for the next ISIAT, you will tell us the results.
Exactly.